sports coverage of the NFL has us at the foot of the Rockies, just west of downtown Denver at Empower Field at Mile High.
Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the San Francisco 49ers and the Denver Broncos. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports.
A nice little gift there to start the ball game as they will begin things at the 40-yard line.
Signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Now Wilson.
Inside the 30.
And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Last play, they didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Now they gain almost 40 yards here.
Execution was one of their watchwords leading up to this one. And on that play, able to execute brilliantly here on this opening drive.
Now Gordon on first down.
And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
The Broncos hit 2-0 here to begin the season, and they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victories, CD.
And I thought they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their dip.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score.
He's got his tight end. It's on the way for the ball. His third touchdown now on the year.
And the Broncos put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
Extra point from McManus is good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
To the 49ers now. First and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Off of play action, and here's Lance.
Oh, he's going to air it out right away. He rifles one that's intercepted. picked off by Ronald Darby. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. So with that pick, Charles, I mean, now they score here. You feel like they're really in the catbird seat in the first quarter.
Yeah, they certainly are, but think about it from the other side. They came into this game thinking they've got to keep up with their opponents. And after being down a score, what's one way to get it done? Fire right back at them. They took the shot.
He's got a man complete. And all the way home for the Broncos score. Tim Patrick, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Broncos are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. McManus's point after is good. And it's now 14 to nothing. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early, first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen, and they need for it to happen now.
And he's going to have a Niners first down as the tackle made at about the 38. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Lance looking to throw it. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Michael O.J. Mudiay. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
After the interception, here's Wilson. And the Niners get there and bring him down. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Here's Wilson. Flush to his right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Wilson. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in. A heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for fourth.
Well, don't tell any defensive coordinator I played for, but that might be considered a win for both teams because defensively, they stopped them short and forced the fourth down. But offensively, they picked up enough yards to give their kicker a better shot if that's what they want to do.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. The handoff goes to Gordon, running left. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
Defensively, he has been a presence in their backfield in the first half. Had a sack earlier, and now he comes up with a big tackle for a loss.
They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Flushed out right. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. It's Wilson, eluding the pressure right, and this is caught for a Bronco touchdown, making a hat trick for Russell Wilson, three touchdown passes now, and the Broncos take a three touchdown lead. Extra point from McManus is good, and it's now 21-0. For a start, 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. Set to get this drive underway. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
Complete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Lance. Well, Lance throws the interception, his third. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
Fred Warner, first-time All-Pro in 2020, in on the stop defensively.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too. Hey,
Throwing on second and eight. Wilson. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Gordon. Touchdown! Russell Wilson now with four touchdown passes on the afternoon as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further. McManus's point after is good, and it is 28-0. So that's not what we expected. 28-0 here in the first as another kickoff is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. They'll start with a run by Mitchell. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. First down, here's Mitchell. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down. This defense for the Broncos, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
Once again, it's Mitchell. And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line. An entertaining start to this one. More to come on EA Sports. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And the 49ers are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. Mitchell will get into the end zone for a 49er touchdown.
I'm not sure that they have illusions right now of, okay, we're going to score 8 times in a row and we're going to be terrific. But to get one, that was huge for them. That has to feel much better right now.
And you do have, you're still in the first half. You do have the entire second half. It's something about that goose egg that just looked bad on that board, but now they've broken it.
Yeah, broken through. Can they maintain the pace? We'll see as we go along.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. Fields it right around the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Well, everything right now that they touch on this side of the football seems to turn to gold. They've scored on 3 straight possessions. That lead continues to grow. And, I mean, if they can get points here, Charles, might almost be an insurmountable comeback for the other side.
I think you make a great case for that. So I'm going to flip it over to the other side. Could they make the big comeback? Certainly. Am I expecting it? Not at all. I think if we don't see a drastic change in how they're playing, this blowout is going to get bigger and bigger before the final gun.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Wilson. And he will find his man Sutton. That's complete. And that will get this beyond the 40 before it's taken down. 22 yards there. First down.
That's just kind of what it is. This is what we've struggled for this defense on game one. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now and light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
On first down, Wilson out to his left. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And this is caught. Touchdown, Broncos. All the talk from Russell Wilson came into the league.
Said, how's he going to see over NFL linemen? He never did, right? At whatever level, he saw through them and found pockets and windows to throw the football. But as you noted, when he's outside the pocket and his vision is totally clear, look out, because he's going to find someone downfield, as we just saw there.
And you combine a big leg with a mile-high air, there's the outcome. This will sail out of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've gotten pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo, the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something out of it in this one.
The sack there by Bradley Chubb. This offense continues to shoot themselves in the foot. And here, another sack.
All game long, we've seen missed assignments, which have led to turnovers, sacks. This group has not played well at all here in the first half.
Now after the sack, Lance and the Niners staring up here at a third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Pat Surtain. And he will bring this down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle. Not a whole lot there on first and goal, and that's what you're looking for defensively. You'll certainly live with giving up just a yard or two in this situation.
Williams will try again. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. It'll be a gain of five, and it's going to set up a third and goal.
We did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, tried his best to get there in this game. So far, he's been denied.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Wilson on the keeper, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Denver. Russell Wilson scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Broncos continue to pull away here this first half. Extra point from McManus is good. And a route is on here in this first half. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. set to get this drive underway. So now, Charles, this drive maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Throwing his lance on third down. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, five interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
But based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a fifth interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
First and 10, it's Wilson. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Nick Bosa, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Tell you what, he did not have much time there to scan the field before he was ducking and covering.
Did it appear to you, as it did to me, that the defensive front won their play really quickly? Meaning the guys in front of him had almost no chance to block him. They were on him in a hurry.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
The offense on third down tonight, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. Wilson. He'll find Sutton on the right side, complete. Touchdown! Cortland Sutton, 28 yards. And the Broncos have taken a 6-touchdown lead. McManus's point after is good. And a rout is on here in this first half. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Well, that's not an easy play for a defensive end, because most of his responsibility has him getting upfield and working. But how about his vision to see where the play was going, crash down inside, and tackled him for a loss.
Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss. To throw, it's Lance. That's complete to John Ross. And this is going to be another first down as he'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 38-yard line. From the gun, a give to Mitchell. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Throwing now is Lance. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. I hate
hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
From the gun on third down, Lance. And that is incomplete.
Nice call by the defense there on third down. Just trying to field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
Go for it, Lance. And now here's another interception. And the Broncos are going to get the ball back on the turnover as they hold on fourth down. All I can do up here is just shake my head. Six interceptions. I cannot imagine what he's thinking between the ears right now.
Well, just think of how it is for his teammates, because after the first few, you know they're going over to him, hey, we'll get him next time. Now they're probably a little bit frustrated. And if you're a receiver, you're thinking to yourself, any ball that's in the air, you become receiver and defensive back. You got to go compete for the ball so you don't get another one picked off.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard.
I think the defense surprised him there with that blitz on first down, but give him credit. Stayed cool under pressure and still found a way through the extra rushers for positive yardage. Well done.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Wilson, throw right side, is going to be caught by Judy. Now the Broncos will use their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Play action. It's Wilson. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another, because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
After the sack on first down, Wilson, he'll let this go deep for Sutton. And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll work this down inside the 30.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure is good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number 3 here. The 49ers going to have the football, and trailing on the scoreboard as we get back underway on EA Sports. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster in the first half. So where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done and there's no going back. And now you have to play this drive by drive. Obviously, come back in this spot, pretty unlikely. But you still have to go out, take pride in your work, and try and put something together here in the second half.
Right back to Mitchell on 2nd down. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
And that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. Now Lance going to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, they certainly aren't lighting up today, Parker, because they've forced big turnovers already. It's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. Lance and company going on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Broncos are going to get the football back in great. Here's a give up the middle. It's Gordon. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Azeez Al-Shaair in to make the stop. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Play action. Now Wilson. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Albert O. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Broncos extend their lead yet again. So remember now, this was all set up by the stop defensively on fourth down. That's what got them this great field position. And then two plays later, they're already in the end zone.
Yeah, partner, funny how it works like that, huh? That's a momentum swing amusement park style. Your defense comes off the field, bouncing, grooving, they're fired up. And it carries over to the other side of the ball.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. And it ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles. But I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But, Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper going.
this one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
From the 25 on second down, Lance. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Well, look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
The Broncos going down. 2 extra defensive backs for third down.
Playing pass all the way.
On third down, here's Mitchell. And some room to work. Touchdown, 49ers. That run going to put him over 100 yards now for the ball game as well.
Yeah, he's really had his way so far, and that's just more of the same right here. All he needs, just a little crease, and off he goes.
Gold able to tack on the extra point. So they do get one score back, but still a long way to go here in the third quarter. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Still well in control of this ball game despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He'll get this one to Patrick. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. There's Wilson to throw. Pass complete to Judy on the out route. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
This offensive game plan has just been sensational. I mean, when you think about all the different ways they've gotten their receivers open so far, it's really been impressive. Scheme, design, execution.
Now a first down carry, it's Williams. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Throwing is Wilson. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. Now Wilson. Intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And the Niners are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. Well, this D, particularly the secondary, has been picked apart at points here tonight. They finally, though, get to the quarterback, get a pick.
And we know this about him. He loves night games, loves the spotlight, loves being the center of attention. I will bet you that he ran out.
There he goes, left side. He's at the 30. 10, 5, touchdown, 49ers. Go ahead and give him the hat trick. He's been in the end zone now 3 times.
You toss your fedora first, okay? You go ahead and do that. But let's be honest about it. That third one, that's the most spectacular run he's had in the ballgame. It's almost as if he's been playing his own game of, can I top this?
one has been more spectacular than the last.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Still comfortably on top, third quarter as they start things here with a first and 10. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They keep it on the ground. Again, Gordon. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
What? 49ers have an extra defensive back on the field, a nickel set for third down. Now Wilson. That's going to be caught by Judy. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now Wilson on first down. This will be caught. Judy. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
The other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
On the counter, here's Gordon. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Step on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Behind the chain, second and 12. Throw is Wilson. And it's a fumble. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. We know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side. A little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you are closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner.
My goodness, 235 yards for him on the ground, as this has been a night to remember to this point. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. From the gun, it's Lance. Open man is Samuel, complete. And out of bounds all the way down at the three. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
Well, I mean, look, obviously there's no 20 or 30-point play in that playbook, but
They can try to end things here on a positive note despite trailing big, and that looks like what they're trying to do here by pushing the ball downfield.
Well, let me go with the heavy cliche then, partner. Just control what you can control right now, and all they can control here is how their final plays develop.
That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one by the line of scrimmage.
The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Well, they made the play there, and I'll guarantee you, their coaches and the other players are screaming at them about their pride. Come on, guys, he's already gotten in three times, you can't give up a fourth one. And on that play, they were able to make the stop.
And you knew they were going to go to him to try to get that fourth.
And why wouldn't they? It's not just getting the fourth. He's the hot hand, so to speak, right? The hot feet in this situation.
Touchdown, 49ers! Ty Davis Price from 4 yards out. And the Niners get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. Gold with the extra point, and that'll cut the lead down a bit to 28. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Goes onto the field, ready to start their next drive. But not that any of the points would be needed, but CeeDee, they've got enough time left here. They could definitely score on this drive, maybe even an ensuing drive as well, if they really want to drive home this landslide victory.
Yeah, we're certainly about to see just how aggressive they want to be here down the stretch. And what some coaches do is they try and meet it halfway, meaning they want to continue to run their offense, but they'll put in a lot of backups to do it and then tell the opposing coach, hey, I had to get them some work too. I can't just let them sit over on the sidelines all the time.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Wilson. And he will find his man Sutton. That's complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 35 before going out. A couple of veterans. Wilson to Sutton there for the Bronco first. Tenth carry for Melvin Gordon. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Albert Okwuegbunam, the intended target. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. Following the penalty, here's Gordon. And he'll get about five here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They stay on the ground. This time it's Williams. And he's only going to get a yard from the 20 to the 19.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The offense on third down tonight, they've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and four. Now it's Wilson. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Patrick. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. He's been big, 2 touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. They'll run it up the middle now, Gordon. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. Now McManus for the extra point. And this one was over a mile ago as they just add on to their big lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Set to get this drive underway. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. They had to run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. On 2nd down, here's Mitchell. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Here we go.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
Hurry, hurry.
Throwing his Lance on 3rd down. And my goodness, another interception. And they've got the huge lead. Now they have another interception on the defensive side. Seems like everything they touch in this one, Charles, turns to gold.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road. It helps seal away one of their best efforts of the season.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. After the interception, here's Wilson. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they'll say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass. Again on 2nd and 10, it's Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Sutton. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. They try the left side here with Williams. And he is going to lose yardage here. It was Eric Armstead coming up quickly and dropping him for a loss. They'll have to deal with a 2nd and 14 now after the loss. Oh, Wilson going to throw. He'll get that complete to Albert O. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. 33 yards that time. Boy, another big play late here for an offense, Charles. It certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long, and I would say that going along with that has been confidence, because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them, and now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
Escaping the pressure right. Under pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. Credit the sack to Fred Warner.
He's certainly one of those quarterbacks that can burn you with his mobility, but that time able to hem him in and get him to the ground.
Perfect descriptor right there about how they kept him in the pocket. Excellent job of containment, but they were still able to continue to bring such strong pressure without letting him escape. But how about those guys in the secondary as well? Kept the coverage tight, plastered to the receivers, and left no real option for him to throw it downfield.
That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal. In primetime, this offense, they gave the nation quite a show, putting up that many points to come away with what will certainly be a memorable win for them.
And Brandon, I think it's as simple as this. Some players, some teams, they're just meant for the big stage. And when they get a chance to play in this type of atmosphere, where all eyes are on them and all the lights are shining brightly, they show up and they show out.
So for the Broncos, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they will hit the road next week. Meanwhile, for San Francisco, they suffer defeat for the first time as they drop to 2-1. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Los Angeles Rams.